In this section, we'll show you how to use the 3Shape Dental System control panel to choose your program language, set up new operators and sites, choose a default tooth library, and how to set up the program for training. The control panel is the communication center. From here, you can access and control the many settings and features of the software. Take a moment to look at the different selections possible. Next, find the System Settings section and choose System Settings. The Smile libraries are listed in the order which they will appear in the Dental Designer. Put your most used libraries near the top of the list. If the PTC training library is not near the top of your list, click on it and click Move Up to move it near the top. Return to the main control panel. In this section, you'll learn how to create an order and import scanned models. Create a new order. Choose yourself as the operator. If you have already created a customer for your practice cases, choose it. If not, add a new customer by clicking the green plus sign. That opens the control panel with a list of customers. Next to the highlighted anatomy icon, you'll see several smaller icons which determine the type of restoration we'll be making. The first full white molar creates a full crown. The second green molar creates a pontic. The tan molar with a white section creates an inlay. The anterior tooth with a white facing creates a veneer. The molar with the brown cutout creates a temporary crown. Finally, the molar over the implant is for use with an artificial tooth. For now, choose the white molar crown to create a full crown. Once you've created an order, you perform the remaining procedures on the case by specifying them from the Dental Manager Orders window. Right-click the mouse on your order. You'll see a list of steps that can be performed on the case. Typically, after creating an order, the next thing you'll do is to scan the models or impressions or import scan files created by the dentist. Notice that the title of the window is prompting you to open the preparation scan for the upper right molar. Navigate to the folder containing the PTC training cases files. C/PTC/3Shape/PTC training cases. If you don't see the PTC training cases folder, click My Computer or This PC in the left column. Open the C drive, then the PTC folder, then 3Shape, then PTC training cases. Open the Crown and Bridge folder, then Single Upper Molar. Click on the PreparationScan.dcm file, and then click Open. From the Info Panel Auto Select pull-down menu, choose All Teeth. Click Continue to start the scan. The program will show a rough mesh of the data as the scanner scans the model. A progress bar at the bottom left estimates the scanner progress. When complete, the mesh will be replaced by a visual representation of the scan. When the die scanning is complete, you'll be given a chance to refine the scans. The first step is to close holes. Select Close Holes on Preparation. Without placing the dies back in the model, reposition the model on the center of the scanner platform in the same position as before. Click Next. When the preview is done, use the circle or square tools to highlight any incomplete areas. When the area you want is highlighted in red, click Continue to complete the scan. click Trim Preparation. Use the circle or square tools to select any areas that you want to trim away. Click Preview to see how the model will be trimmed. When you are satisfied with the model, click Next. Next, we will cover the tools you will use to design a case. The purpose of this section is to become familiar with the basic tools and their effect, not to design teeth. The full procedure to design a case is covered in another course. It is important that you understand and become proficient using the tools in this part of the course. If you do not devote enough time perfecting the use of the tools here, you will certainly encounter difficulty later. Take a look at the screen for a moment. The case is centered in the window. At the top of the screen is the workflow bar, an overall progress indicator. The left column shows the design steps and the design tools for working in the current workflow section. On the right is a toolbar showing all of the viewing tools that apply for the current step. Next to the toolbar is a series of visualization sliders, or settings that control the visibility of the layers in the design. Without pressing a mouse button, move the mouse pointer to the top center of the screen. Hold down the right button and drag the mouse pointer straight downward, then drag back up. Notice how the case rotates on the screen, following your movement. Your view is rotating on a horizontal axis. Don't worry if the case starts to look a little crooked. That's because it's difficult to drag perfectly straight. We'll show you how to compensate for that in a moment. If your view is in an unusable position, correcting it is easy. Right-click drag until the surface you want to see is facing you. Note the flat bottom edge of the model. Keep your eye on that edge as you go. Drag down diagonally in the direction the edge is slanted until it is horizontal. Drag horizontally until the desired surface faces you. Then, drag vertically. Again, drag until the desired surface faces you. Drag diagonally in the direction of the slant until the bottom edge is horizontal. Drag horizontally until the desired surface faces you, then drag vertically. Practice this triangular movement until you can do it with confidence. In the insertion direction panel, you'll see 8 arrows arranged in a circle. As you hover the mouse over each arrow, an arrow on the die will show you how it will affect the insertion direction. Click the arrow that points most directly toward the buckle several times. Each time you click it, the insertion direction rotates in the direction of the arrow by the number of degrees in the step setting. Click enough times that the lingual surface of the prep starts turning red. That indicates that the crown will not seat in that direction. Rotate the case a few directions so you can clearly see how the insertion direction would be affected. In this section, you'll learn how to establish the final margin of the crown. The margin is key to a successful restoration that fits well, does not harm the gingiva, and keeps the tooth healthy without decay. The margin line panel allows you to fine-tune the margin that the program calculated from the rough margin points. Rotate the case to view the margin all the way around the die. Click the mouse above or below the margin line a few times and notice how the margin changes. The program moves the line to where you click and blends the line smoothly into the existing margin. You can vary how smooth that transition is. Hold down the control key on the keyboard while you hover the mouse pointer over the margin line. The circle indicates how much blending will occur. Use the mouse wheel to make the circle larger. Click above and below the margin a few times to see how the margin blends smoothly over a longer distance. Drag along the margin to move several points at once. Open the Difference Map panel, then click Preview at the top of the screen. The Difference Map controls the coloring of the interface, and it can be very informative. For example, click Drill Compensation. In many cases, you'll see drill compensation around the sharp edges of a prep. It shows you that the die interface thickness has been increased where a rotating drill would be too big to reach into the sharp inner angle of the crown. Click Thickness to see how the interface compares to the surface of the prep. Yellow areas, like at the margin, are very thin. Red areas, like the areas of drill compensation, are thicker. Click Next when you are done. The Anatomy Design section is where you create the shape of the restoration using the tools of the Smile Composer. Open the Choosing Smile Library panel. Click the image of the teeth to bring up a list of smile libraries. Your default smile library, the one you saw earlier at the top of the list in the control panel, has been selected to use for this crown. But let's see how you can select a different library tooth. In the Sculpt panel's Single Tooth Tools, click on the Individual Transformation tool. Click on the tooth, and a number of colored control points will appear. Use the red points to rotate the tooth on the indicated axis. The green points stretch or compress the tooth. In a profile view, the yellow points cause the tooth to be skewed at an angle. The part of the tooth closest to the yellow point stretches along the indicated axis, while the farthest part of the tooth remains unchanged. Try them all, rotating to different views to become proficient with the tool. Look how the restoration fits the margin. If the margin isn't exposed in a few places, you might have made the tooth too big. If most of the margin is visible, you're likely too small. If your model prevents you from seeing the margin, you can use the S key to show or hide the scan. The first slider in the visualization sliders allows you to adjust the opacity of the preparation scan. Try it. It's time to connect the crown to the margins of the prep. The margin line offset is the thickness of the restoration at the margin. Offset angle is the angle at which the restoration leaves the margin, and it affects the emergence angle of the restoration. Extension offset is the distance from the margin that the offset angle will be enforced. These settings are set from the defaults for the material in the control panel. Leave the default settings for now. Warning: don't use the Enter key after entering numbers into the Connect settings. The program will think you're done with the crown and exit the Anatomy Design section. If that happens, use the back arrow in the upper left corner to return. If the crown lifts off the die, just uncheck the Lift Anatomy Off button like we showed you earlier. You can adjust the size of the area you're morphing by adjusting the slider in the individual morphing panel. The green circle indicates the size of the area that will morph. An alternate method is to hold down the Shift key while scrolling the mouse wheel. Try it. We'll start with the three variations of the tool and what they have in common. First is the Add tool, the red plus sign. Click it, or use its keyboard shortcut, the plus key on the numeric keypad. If any of the four desired thickness controls below the black line are on, click them off. A red circle shows the size of the area that will be affected by the Add tool. Drag it across the surface of your tooth, and you'll see how you can quickly overdo it, especially if you drag slowly. Undo that. Return to the Sculpt panel and find the Smart Tools in the third row. Click on the first, Contacts and Smoothing. Open the Contacts and Smoothing panel. In this panel, you can enforce minimum thickness and contact with the surrounding teeth. The first setting, Minimum Thickness, defaults to the thickness specified in the control panel for the material being used. If you set it below the material's minimum, it will turn red, indicating a problem. Click the green play button, and the program will add to any areas of the crown that are below the minimum. Now click the articulator icon in the upper right corner of the palette. Turn on the antagonist scan. Scale and rotate your view until you have a partial view of the occlusal surface of your crown. Be sure that the Record Contacts box is checked. Click the green Play button in the lower left corner. The articulator moves through the excursions and records the contacts on the teeth. Turn off the antagonist scan. If you have any marks on the restoration, set the minimum distance to 0 mm and click Adapt Designs. The program will reduce the crown, removing the marks.